Welcome to the EA Sports Tournament of Legends. And fans, the ever so popular tournament bracket. Tonight we really have an interesting matchup at the center position. Number 33 is the great leader out on the floor for his team.
The player he'll be guarding tonight is also a great floor general, Brad. This should be a classic matchup.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court and we'll see how this one plays out. Points of emphasis, Dick. What do you got for us?
First off, an offensive attack, which is balanced and all players are a threat to score, is very difficult to defend. Secondly, they have to make smart substitutions. They can't expect their players to play hard for 40 minutes. Subs have to be made. Finally, own the defensive glass by blocking out as soon as the shot goes up.
Early in the ball game, these two teams try to set their particular tempo. They're working around the perimeter. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The lane. Both teams are looking to get something going here.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
He tries the jumper. Knocked it down. Gave it up with a good look. Off the mark. Number 10 receives the pass. And a momentary look from three-point land. Number 33 is charged with the foul. Who will win the battle of tempos here tonight? That's what we want to know right now, Dick.
Well, Brad, controlling a tempo can be very difficult, especially for the entire game. But if you stick with your strengths and make changes when needed, winning becomes a lot easier.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. For the bucket. Up and in.
That's Matador defense. Nobody coming over. Nobody giving any help. I mean, that's how you see better defense on a playground.
The point guard takes the pass. Baseline jumper. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Brad, he's not getting any help out there. It's basically one against five. Not good odds.
Number 31 handles the feed. Goes up for two.
The land.
On the dribble, gives it up. He tries the jumper. Busts the jumper. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
Gave it up. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
That stat doesn't surprise me, Brad. The pace of the game has been pretty slow.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Up and in. On the dribble, gives it up. The skip pass is picked off. For two. They are red hot right now.
They're feeling it from everybody on the floor, Brad. They're getting it from every spot on the court. They're doing a nice job of getting back on D.
Number 23 receives the pass.
Up and inside.
The man asking for a screen here.
Hey, whether it ends up in a roll or fade, its well-executed two-man game is always a treat to watch.
Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Gave it up. He shoots from the elbow.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
The small forward takes the pass.
Defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
Number two. He cashed in on the layup and gets the foul.
He knew he was going to get fouled, Brad, but he took the hit like a man.
To the charity stripe. He gets it to go. Well, whose team tempo went out? That's a question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
Turns it over. On the dribble, gives it up. Pull-up jumper, left side. Missed the jumper.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
Takes his jumper, and it's in and out. Balanced teams, Dick. What are some of the things that they'll try to accomplish when they step out on the court?
They try to really get balanced in that they'll get some points with tempo by creating a little fast pace and then slow it down and executing their half-court set, getting high-percentage shots.
Now the turnaround jumper. Snatches it away.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
Gave it up. For the bucket, the layup.
That's worth another look.
He's all alone. Misses the bomb.
Great elevator man. That's the elevator guy. What a high riser.
There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
Two teams who are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
The small forward takes the pass. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. The small forward with the ball. Outside jumper. There was no doubt about that one. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
The tempo is definitely on the slower side. Something that works well for some teams and not so well for others.
Moving it around the perimeter. Jumper. Nails a sweet jumper.
Let's go up to the booth and review that one.
Cross court. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, field the defensive player on your hip, going one way, and spin back the other way.
Unloads a three. Goes in. The Jayhawks have a number of seniors in their lineup. That factor alone will definitely help their cause. We're going to move it around the perimeter. Fantastic post defense, Dick.
Hey, just like you, Mr. Nestler, that's great D.
The power forward takes the feed. Working it around the perimeter. Now the turnaround jumper. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
Looking for a good shot. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Number 23 takes the pass.
Pushing that basketball.
On the dribble, gives it up.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
The shooting guard with the ball and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad.
They work the perimeter. Forgets the rejection. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Brad and Dick, not too many differences between these two players. Seems as though they're almost canceling each other out on the floor. This now could come down to which team is stronger.
Thanks, Aaron. Our trusty sideline reporter, Aaron Andrews, keeping everyone on their toes there on the sideline. Number 22 gets the ball. He's going to muscle it up and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Jumper won't go. Number 20 gets the pass.
Had a little trap really well there, Brad.
For the bucket. Up and in. On the outside.
Hey, Brad, coach is going to have to make some substitutions. Some of these kids are tired.
Number 23 handles the feed. Spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
The point guard gets the ball. They call three ticks.
Got busted waiting for a screen.
Number 11 makes his first substitution.
I'll tell you what I like about him, Brad. He brings all kinds of energy to the floor.
On the outside.
Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior.
The small forward handles the pass. Gave it up. He goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively.
The small forward takes the feed. Goes up for two. The lay-in. Number 43 with the ball. Cross court. With lots of room, he drains the long-range bomb. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game. Richard?
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
The shooting guard takes the feed. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beat.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
Up and in. He gets the board. The small forward takes the pass.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He was looking for the call, and he got it on himself. Offensive foul.
Definitely an offensive foul, no doubt about it. He beats him to the spot.
The low block. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works. That young man has a lot of skill. When we're talking about post play, baby, He's got a bunch of moves with his back to the basket, and he also can face up as well.
Look at that spacing.
He attempts the jump shot. The missed shot. On the dribble, gives it up. For two, the layup. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
Long possessions, a few fast breaks is the reason for that, Brad.
They'll work it around the arc. For two, up and in. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
With the big shot. And it's no good from three-point range. Number four takes the pass. Gave it up. He bombs from outside. I'm not sure that's who you want shooting the three.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Number 22 is put back in the game.
Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad.
From way downtown. Can't get the long jumper. Would have been good for three. At the end of the first half, the Tar Heels lead by 14. Let's take a look back and watch the play of the half. One half of basketball is finished. Dick, what about those points of emphasis?
Brad, I look at the graphic, and there are definitely not enough check marks. That indicates that the team is not playing their style. It's very difficult to win often if you're not playing your style.
They've got to do what they do and play their style. Some great points there, Mr. Vitale. Let's see how they make out the second half. Number 10 makes the substitution back into the ballgame.
Well, Brad, it's going to be interesting to see what kind of energy he comes with.
Dick, we're heading into the second half in our player matchup. It's going about the way we thought it would.
Well, they're really doing a great job. Both guys getting good shots, really making them count, and really their teammates are getting them the ball at the right time.
North Carolina is killing the opposition on the glass in the first half.
Hey, these kids know what it takes to win big games, Brad. If you can win the rebounding battle on any given night, you have a great shot of winning the ball game.
For the bucket, the layup. Goes up for two with the layup. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
The Tar Heels did a superb job of boxing out in the first half. The coaching staff urged the players to continue to rebound in this manner. Dick, this was also a point of emphasis that you brought up earlier. Watch for the stellar rebounding to continue in the second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Dumps it in. He rejects it. 10 seconds with a rejection. And the ball goes out of play. The Tar Heels will play up-tempo at one end and in the half court at the other end. Wouldn't you agree, Dick?
You know, balanced teams will definitely give you a combination of the two styles. Some teams will play up-tempo on offense and be half-court oriented at the defensive end. Other balanced teams may play in the half court offensively and really look to pressure their opponents in the full court.
Up and in. A little two-man action. He takes a three. He misses it. And the jam. On the dribble, gives it up. For two, perfectly executed. Puts up the jumper. Missed the jumper. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Number 22 receives the pass. 10 seconds on the clock. Looking for a good shot. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? The point guard with the ball. Inside. Playing for the... He blocks the shot. Buries it. Working around the perimeter. Ten on the shot clock. And Dick, they run out of time there.
Hey, that defense is simply ferocious, Brad.
Looking for the call, and he got it out himself. Offensive foul.
Definitely an offensive foul, no doubt about it. He beats him to the spot.
Another turnover.
We're not talking out for turnovers either.
Was that beautiful or what? The small forward takes the pass.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
That's a foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. Number 20 gets the pass. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Defense! bucket. The layup. Well, whose team Temple went out? That's a question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, Temple is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
Inside. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Number 23 takes the pass. Tries for two. Up and in. Boy, terrible execution on offense. Number 21 takes the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Way off target. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Cross court.
It's a human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Or gets a hand in the way. Number 10 takes the pass. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission. Up and inside.
Open shot. Knocks it down.
What a great touch. Good baseline drive. Squared his body. Well, here comes some pressure.
The Jayhawks are all about playing in the half court and controlling the tempo, would you say, Dick?
These types of teams will be pretty solid in the half and quarter court. Throughout the season, they will perfect their half court play. Offensively, they'll get better, and defensively, they'll improve as well.
Eludes the trap there. Kicks it out. He could not get more wide open. Misses from three. Gave it up. For the bucket. Tickles the twine. Check it out here. A nominee for our Pontiac game-changing performance. The center takes the pass. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Goes up for two. The layup. They're going to call this one a backcourt violation, Dick.
You can't make mistakes like that too often, Brad.
Two-thirds of the way through this game now, Richard. How's the player matchup shaping up?
I tell you, it's been so balanced and so even. Both kids have really responded to the task at hand, and they really want the ball. That really excites me. They don't run away. They want the ball.
Moving it around the perimeter. In the clear. 23. Dials long distance.
Dump it inside.
Goes up for two. The Jayhawks have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Brady's on fire. He wants it.
He's asking for it on the low block, and they don't get it to him. And the ball goes out of bounds. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
On the dribble, gives it up, tries for two, up and in. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
Two teams are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Working it around the perimeter. With the J. Nope. For two. The land. Who will win the battle of tempos here tonight? That's what we want to know right now, Dick.
Well, Brad, controlling the tempo can be very difficult, especially for the entire game. But if you stick with your strengths and make changes when needed, winning becomes a lot easier.
Pressure's getting to him. Looking for a good shot. He makes the block. Gets the rejection. The Jayhawks are going to have to switch some things up here, Mr. Vitale. When you consider time and score, I think it's time for them to ditch the half-court style and get some easy baskets.
They'll need some quick scores and defensive stops, Brad. That's the only way they'll be able to overcome this deficit. Playing up tempo may not be their thing, but it's their only chance of getting back into this game.
They work the perimeter. He shoots the jumper. The Jayhawks have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Tries for two. Up and in. On the outside. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
The small forward receives the ball from the top of the key and come up short. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game. Richard?
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
On the outside. turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Number 11 receives the pass. He's in the clear. Misses the tray. From the baseline, they'll bring it out on top. He can't get any more open than that. For two, the lay-in.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Pass on the post, turnaround jumper. He grabs the board. Cross court. For the bucket. Was that beautiful or what?
Spacing.
Now the turnaround jumper.
Hey, you don't have to be a space eater, aka a big guy, to get on board. You just have to be relentless.
Gave it up. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
As we continue to track the game's tempo.
Long possessions, a few fast breaks is the reason for that, Brad.
He passes it out of the trap. Good! Work it around the arc. He launches the bomb, and he can't hit the shot. Number 21 gets the ball. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Eludes the trap there. Number 4 takes the feed. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
It's a 9-point lead.
Well, 9 points still keeps you in the game, though, Brad. They can't have a breakdown here, though.
Goes up with it. He rips the nets for another score.
He's absolutely unconscious.
A lot of time to go now, Dick, on a 7-point lead.
That's right, Brad. A lot of time. They don't need to start forcing shots.
The shooting guard receives the ball. Looking for a good shot. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Weak side rebound. They keep it alive, Dick. 9 points is the difference now.
A difference that can change in a heartbeat if you ain't careful, Brad.
Dumps it in. Tries for two.
They got a foul quickly here.
I gotta be sure they'll continue to look to foul here, Dick. The Vic, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
They're set to throw it in from the side. The lead is now 7 points.
This game is still up for grabs, Brad. Trying to execute on the inbounds.
And yet another foul. Ball's coming from the sideline. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And the clock stopped for the foul. Ball coming in from the sideline. And yet another foul. He is going to the line. Foul shot, no good. Timeout's called.
Time is not on their side right now, Brad. They need some big shots, baby.
I wouldn't mind seeing him change things up a little bit, Dick, here.
I wouldn't be surprised either.
The small forward gets the pass. They work it around the perimeter, takes the jumper, and it's in and out. Number 21 is caught for his last foul. Number 33 to the line for the 1-1. Wide, short, long, doesn't matter, doesn't go. They call for a TO, Dick.
Hey, time is their worst enemy at this point, Brad. They're going to have to bear down and get some stops that convert at the other end.
The player's got a much-needed breather with that timeout. He goes right past the trip, and the shot blocks. It's all about playing your team style, Nick. Any final thoughts?
Well, Brad, the points of emphasis provide some valuable hints, suggestions, which can and should result in a better team performance. Achieving them may not always result in a win, but it does make winning more likely.
Teams are so diverse these days. They play all different styles, and it's a matter of knowing your personnel, primarily their strengths and weaknesses. I don't know about you, Dick, but I think today's Pontiac game-changing performance was obvious out there on the court. Dick, we know the TV business. You've got to have marquee matchups, but it's still about team basketball.
Well, that's how you win. You got to execute as a team. You got to make sure the right people shoot the shot. And I'll tell you, the PTPers responded, but they responded within a team concept.
North Carolina wins the game.
They'll be happy to walk away with a victory from such an evenly matched opponent.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.